morning, everyone. If you would, please go ahead and take your seats and make your way to your tables. We're going to get the program underway in just a moment. So that we remind everybody not to text and drive. With that, I know you're very anxious to hear from our officials on our State of the Community for 2013. So with that, I want to get us started by asking Representative Geoff Duncan to come lead us in the invocation and our Pledge of Allegiance.
It is an honor for me to pray for this group today on this National Day of Prayer. If you would, please bow your heads. Dear Lord, thank you so much for these blessings that you've given to this community and to this state and to this country. Lord, I ask you to let us be great stewards of each and every one of these blessings. Protect our children in our schools. Protect our teachers in our schools. Protect our small businesses and everyone in this community. Give us the strength to be a bold example to each and every person around us. God, I ask that you give us the strength each and every day to wake up and to not just make a point, but to make a difference. Bless this food to our body. It's in your name we pray. Amen.
People, please join me in the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Representative Duncan, thank you for that heartfelt prayer. I want to tell you take just a minute to tell you what the Chamber of Commerce has been doing for you over the last year. In 2012, we had 9 new companies move into the Cumming-Forsyth County area. One of those was IUS Technologies, who we very much appreciate. We also had 9 companies that expanded. That created 762 new jobs in our community. And they spent more than $71 million in capital. We've already had a great start to the year. We've had 6 projects that have completed, and they are going to generate over 100 new jobs and $5 million in capital investment. So thank you to James and the hardworking staff at the Chamber for working for us. With that, I want to recognize all the elected officials that are not going to be on the podium today. So if you'll hold your applause to the end, we'll thank them all at the end as a group. First, Senator Steve Gooch. Representative Mark Hamilton. Representative Geoff Duncan. Mayor of Milton, Joe Lockwood. Chair of the Dawson County Chamber of Commissioners, Mike Berg. Commissioner Brian Tam, Commissioner Todd Levent, Commissioner Jim Bob, Commissioner Cindy Mills, County Manager Doug Dare, Deputy County Manager Tim Merritt, City Councilman Rupert Sexton, Councilman Quincy Holton. City Councilman John Hughes. City Manager Gerald Blackburn. Board of Education Member Ann Crowe. Board of Education Member Tom Cleveland. Board of Education Member Kristen Morrissey. And we have our Teacher of the Year with us today, Nick Crowder. We have Representative for Saxby Chambliss, Bobby McMillan. Representative for Congressman Woodall, Deborah Perot. And Representative for Senator Johnny Isaacson, I cannot read my own handwriting. Thank you, I am so sorry. Well, our chamber has an exciting opportunity every year to host the State of the Community. And we're only able to do this with the partnership of the Council for Quality Growth, who hosts the event with us. So I'd like to thank Michael Harris and his staff for all their efforts in making this event possible. And at this time, I'd like to introduce the 2013 Council for Quality Growth Chairman, Mason Zimmerman.
Thank you very much. I'm Mason Zimmerman. It's a pleasure to be here, and let me also welcome you. What a great turnout today. What a great event. I want to also welcome the representatives that were introduced and tell you a little bit about the council. The Council of Quality Growth has been around about 30 years. Its mission is to promote balanced and responsible growth throughout the metro Atlanta area. And we do it in four different ways, through information, education, advocacy, and programs. So those are the four tools we use to serve our members. And this is one of the things that we do, is to help support programs around the region where we all get to learn what's going on in the metro area and learn from one another. So I would encourage you at your tables today to get to know somebody and pass business cards and compare notes. It's an exciting time in the metro area. I'd like to thank also the council members that are here today to invest in our mission and help us do it, and also to thank Michael and Jennifer and James and the staff that actually do all the work. If you're not a member of the council, I encourage you to look into it. We're the only member, we only organization of our kind in the metro area that supports and fosters regional dialogue and is down in the level of issues like zoning issues, legislative issues, the things that happen in this metro area to support development. Our board is the strongest board. It's a very diverse group of board members, and we're engaged in the development of this community. So we're proud to co-host this event today. Let me also say that this event is not unlike events we've already done this year. We've already hosted the state of Gwinnett County, the state of DeKalb County, and the state of Cherokee County. Each of those events have record attendance and record sponsorship, much like today's event. So we're really encouraged with the outpouring we see in the community to come out and sort of get our heads up and move ahead and develop in this region. So let me also be diligent about recognizing our sponsors and thanking them for their contributions to the council. So bear with me. First, I'd like to welcome our title sponsor and ask Freda Hardage to come with Northside Hospital-Forsyth to make some sponsor remarks. Freda?
So I know everybody's expecting Lynn Jackson, but I am Lynn Jackson. We just did a great remake up in Forsyth. You too can look like this and be Lynn Jackson. So I'm sorry, Lynn had an unexpected emergency that came up. Everything's fine, but she couldn't get here. So we wanted to just tell you how pleased we are to be in Forsyth County and how happy we are to be a part of this event today. And as always, if you ever need us, please let us know. Northside Hospital Forsyth there for you. Thanks.
Please welcome Fran, Forehand, Regional North Manager for Georgia Power Company.
Good morning. It is a pleasure being here with you this morning. It really is a no-brainer for Georgia Power to continue to sponsor this wonderful event. Where else can you get a private school-type education and public school systems here than in Forsyth County? Also, just my humble opinion, but I think the Chamber of Commerce is really rocking the development and recruiting international businesses to Forsyth County. Economic development is really on a roll. I personally want to thank the wonderful partnership between Georgia Power and Forsyth County. I look forward to the many, many years after today and continuing that wonderful working relationship. Thank you.
Thank you. I'd also like to thank our platinum sponsor, Kevin Reiner of Gas South, who was not able to join us today. Our luncheon sponsor today is Wakefield Beasley. Our program sponsors are Winter Construction and Turner Construction. And believe it or not, we have a dessert sponsor, so everybody enjoy your desserts, Anchor Home Mortgage. Our gold sponsors today, American Proteins, AT&T, Carter Global Lee, Jacobs, Lennar, Metcan, Rialto, Moreland Altavelli Associates, and Kaiser Permanente. Our silver sponsors today are Brown & Caldwell, Edward Andrews Homes, and our bronze sponsors, D.R. Horton, Hayes James Associates, Lipscomb, Johnson, Sleaser, Daly & Smith, and the University of North Georgia Continuing Education. And our patron sponsor is Arcades. Now how about that for a lineup of very strong sponsors who have seen fit to step up and put money down, put their names in front of this group. I'm really impressed by that, and I want to give them a hand. Thank you. I'd like to call the speakers to the stage now. What we're going to do, I'll continue to eat. What we want to do is have a little bit of a panel discussion. I'd like to invite Chairman Amos, Mayor Gravitt, and Chair White to the stage for an introduction. And y'all are ready to come on up. We'll do that now. Something that's a break in the program. It's an opportune time to take a picture of the MC when there's a problem. Put that in the paper and speak that. Okay, so we're going to have each of our speakers up here, and then we're going to come up to the podium and have a presentation, and then have an opportunity at the end for some questions and answers. So, first, we please welcome Chairman Amos. Pete Amos was elected in 2010 to serve as the District 1 Commissioner for the 2011-14 term. In January, he was elected by his fellow commissioners to serve as Chairman for 2013. Chairman Amos is a former member of the Forsyth County Planning Commission and served as the Planning Commission's Chairman for 6 years. Please join me in welcoming Chairman Amos.
Raised my family here and building a heritage that now stems to my grandchildren being raised in this county. So South County is not just a place to me, but it's a sense of accomplishment, a sense of progress, and a sense of pride. I want to thank, because each year the Chamber of Commerce and the Council of Quality Growth perform the Central Public Service planning this event. It's not an easy task bringing three governments together on the stage together. It's kind of like herd and cattle. Some of them stray every once in a while. So I want to thank James McCoy of the Chamber, Michael Parrish of the Council of Quality Growth for this, and their staff for planning and execution of the session. For those of you who have not had the pleasure of attending an event at this venue, welcome to the region's most state-of-the-art facility. Since its inception in 2010, the South Conference Center at Lanier Tech has become not only a regional destination, but also a vital hub for economic activity that will surely continue for decades to come. I'm just honored to speak today alongside the Honorable Mayor Ford Gravitt, the Board of Education Chair, Honorable Darla. It's an honor to be up here with you. Linda Cole did a great introduction by all of our county commissioners, and without them on this board to help the whole county, it's a pleasure to serve these guys. We do a good job, I think, and we have a great board. The staff does a great time. Doug Dare, Tim Merritt both put the hearts in this. But finally, and perhaps most importantly, I'd like to thank the business leaders and the community stakeholders, and especially the taxpayers of Forsyth County for your continued dedication to Forsyth County. Without their commitment to champion our community's success, I would not be able to report this today. Forsyth County's economic forecast is stronger than ever. In my household, I have a philosophy that, you know, been believing that describing our community's process and, I have a philosophy that seeing is believing. Rather than describing our community's progress and wasting the technology afforded in this wonderful venue, I want to show you a short video at this time. Please.
Forsyth County, a great place to call home, and named the healthiest county in Georgia.
Committed to providing top-notch public safety services.
Projects that enhance our community.
Continuing to plan and prepare for the future.
great video.
That makes my job easier up here to watch that.
As you can see, Forsyth County is a thriving county. We are thriving. We are ready to assume our position as a leader in the global marketplace. At every turn, you can see the signs of progress throughout the county. In 1976, more than three decades ago, I think Darla and I were about the same age when all that started a long time. We constructed the current jail and courthouse. But over time, and under the strains of unprecedented growth, these structures have outbuilt our community needs. The wheels of justice slowed down, public safety presented a looming challenge, and Forsyth County taxpayers anxiously called by approving the SPLOST 7 ballot box. So now we are underway with a new jail and courthouse, which is great. See, Forsyth County citizens, do not fear a challenge. We embrace it at its core and transform it into opportunities to quench our thirst for progress here in the county. With the construction of the county's new courthouse and jail expansion beginning in July, the project will include an enhanced security system, a connected thoroughfare to contain inmate movement and overall efficiencies that will save taxpayers the money while preserving public safety. Must a 158,000 square foot courthouse and 170,000 square foot jail complete, renovations will start on the existing courthouse. This will eliminate the need for costly rental properties throughout the county and city. These buildings will be constructed with a bold vision to serve our community for many years to come. I have issued a clear challenge to our project teams to deliver these projects both on time and within the budget we have set for them. We do not want any waste of this money. Also, public safety is among the highest priorities for Forsyth County. As you saw in the video, last year we opened a new fire station 4 in the Ducktown community. We acquired a new ladder truck, an engine for the fire department. And this summer we will open a new fire station in the Matt community, Fire Station 3. In addition, last year the county added 5 additional severe weather sirens, bringing the total number of 17 sirens to the county. So if you don't hear one, let somebody know. But if you do hear it and wakes you up in the middle of the night, don't call and complain. That's what it's supposed to do. But give Forsyth County's crown jewels for house in our outstanding parks and recreation amenities. Without these amenities, we would not enjoy the high quality of life we enjoy today. In fact, there's little doubt that these amenities, when combined with our award-winning healthcare system, this is an important factor in naming Forsyth County the healthiest county in Georgia. That was an honor for this. So with the addition of 4 new passive parks last year, Forsyth County added more than 280 acres of green space. That includes pavilions, natural playgrounds, mountain bike trail, a spray pad, and a canoe launch. These parks and more than 500 acres of future parks in Nearland, Eagles Beach, and Matt were all made possible through a combination of voter-approved parks, recreation and green space bonds, SPLOST impact fees. As you saw in the video, late March, Forsyth County broke ground on a new voter-approved animal shelter. The new shelter will be located in Northern Forsyth, and it will be a state park facility that is scheduled for completion in early 2014. The success that our community has enjoyed is as a result of a strong vision met by a community committed to reaching new heights and achieving unparalleled success. Our community certainly has not been exempt from the economic challenges faced by other communities nationwide. However, thanks to the steadfast commitment of business leaders like you, our economic fabric has continued to expand and we have seen impressive investments by critical business sector. When the business is determined where it wants to invest, it looks at several factors, including the economic stability of the local government. I am pleased that Forsyth County's financial condition remains strong today. As one of the 3 counties in the state of Georgia with a AAA bond rate for Moody's, Forsyth County is able to bond critical infrastructure improvements essential to protecting the quality of life of families while also remaining competitive and attracting new jobs. Our families enjoy one of the lowest tax rates in the metro Atlanta area, and the sales tax receipts are continuing to demonstrate a positive trend, with collections up 6% over 2011. Today, the Chamber and Development Authority of Forsyth County have implemented a focused economic development plan targeting the healthcare sector, international corporations, and retail and technology. And I can tell you today that our partnership and our strategy are paying off. The South County is home to more than 56,000 employees working in more than 8,000 businesses that call the South County home, 62 of which are international firms. Of course, the jobs come to families, the families come to houses. 2012, the South County led the state of Georgia with 2,300 new residential dwelling units, almost doubling the permit number in 2011. And I spoke earlier about one of the first requirements in the industry is having a stable local government. Another requirement is a well-educated workforce. We are proud of the county and the city to welcome the University of North Georgia to our community. Their investment in our community brings not only essential education, but also hopes to countless students who we hope will one day reinvest in Forsyth County. As Parks Foundation have continued to struggle, we have focused a lot of our attention on reinforcing our position as a great place to live, a great place to work, a great place to play, and a great place to retire. This is just a great county. I don't see anybody to leave this. Together as a community committed to achieving greatness, we will work to protect our community for generations to come by offering our citizens the best quality of life possible in this county. On behalf of the Board of Commissioners and the entire Forsyth County government, I want to thank you for allowing us the opportunity to speak here today. Enjoy your meal. Thank the Chamber of Commerce again. Thank y'all again. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Chairman Amos. Thank you for your leadership. You know, it's amazing to think how much this county and this part of the region has grown over the last 20 years. You guys know it better than anybody. But if you think about where Cumming-Forsyth was 20 years ago and where it is now and where it's headed, it's absolutely unbelievable. I mean, it's great infrastructure, it's great leadership, it's great real estate, but you just look at what you guys have accomplished in the last 10 years anyway. It's really amazing. And no one's had a better seat at the table than our next speaker, who really kind of needs no introduction, but I'm going to introduce him anyway. Mayor Gravitt has been the mayor of Cumming for 44 years. He's a Forsyth County native son. He was first elected as city councilman in 1964 and served through 1968. In 1969, he was elected mayor, the youngest in the history of the town, and has served continuously since that date. So, with no further introduction, Mayor Gravitt, on board with him on.
Thank you very much, Mason, for those kind remarks. Thank you, Commissioner Amos, for those remarks in reference to coming in for South County's future. You know, it sounds like I've been mayor since Abraham Lincoln. But I wasn't always in politics. But during part of my political career, I spent 42 years in automobile repair business, all phases of repair. So I did that 44 years raising a family. And at the same time, being involved in local government. I want to thank the Chamber of Commerce, the Council for Quality Growth, certainly all the public officials, and I'll not go into naming all of them, but just a few, the state delegation, Representative Mark Hamilton, Senator Jack Murphy, and Senator Duke certainly played an important part here in this legislative season, working with the city, keeping us informed, and also getting the city help with various intersection and roads throughout Cumming. We appreciate the work that Representative Hamilton and Senator Murphy and Senator Gooch did with that. Also, the Board of Education. Obviously, we wouldn't be as prosperous and as healthy and as educated as most people are today without the Board of Education. And Dr. Buster Evans, you'd be interested to hear that last week I got a call from Boca Raton, Florida, from a friend of a friend who is being relocated their job in to Alpharetta, Georgia. And said that we like, even though we're going to be working in Alpharetta, we've researched all the school systems and we found out that Forsyth County has the best school system, and that's where we're going to buy our house and coming in Forsyth County. So they're going to be moving from Florida, Boca Raton, Florida, to Cumming, Georgia, and be working in Alpharetta, Georgia. So we were proud to hear, and we get a lot of calls like that from all over the country, people relocating. And we know we're growing. I think the hospital, Northside Forsyth, delivered over 2,000 babies last year. So we know Forsyth County and Cumming, Georgia is growing. And we thank the Board of Education for their commitment to coming in Forsyth County's education. We appreciate that. Also, University System of North Georgia, the new campus, we appreciate the good work and dedication that North Georgia has presented itself to coming for. They opened last year, expecting about 400 students, and I think they did close to 800. So we're looking to fill additional campus classes now. So hopefully that'll work out great for the years to come for education, higher education, in coming in Forsyth County and surrounding area. Also, I'd like to thank, obviously without our voters and our constituency, we wouldn't be here today, but I'd like to personally thank our city councilmen who are here today. We have Quincy Holton, Rupert Sexton, and John D. Pugh. Ralph Curry has recently had surgery, and Lewis Ledbetter said somebody had to hold the shop, so he had to work. Also, Gerald Blackman, our city manager, and Steve Bennett, assistant city manager, and director of cultural arts, and catch-all, Linda Hurd, and also Angie Mullinax. They all contribute to what we are today in the city of Cumming and what we get done. They all do a great job. Now, as far as the state of the city of Cumming, Georgia, I don't think it's ever been better. I don't think it's ever been in better hands. We just received our audit from an independent audit council, and we have AAA plus audit. Our financial situation is great. The economic of Cumming in Forsyth County is growing. We have a great economic outlook. I think from the numbers that I've seen, Cumming, Georgia is only about 6.5% unemployment. And that's due to whenever the economy tanked 7 years ago, started slowing down, a lot of our employment was construction industry, not only in Cumming but Forsyth County. But due to the fact that a lot of the construction industry has gone out of business, and a lot of it has moved, I understand, to the Louisiana coast and to the New Jersey coast and also to Texas, it's hard to get construction contractors in this area now. It's not a lot of it. So with all the construction that's going to be going on, Turner and Winter Construction, who is the management team for the construction of our courthouse and jail, will be holding, I believe, a meeting here today to try to get contractors and any of you that is in that kind of business or has friends. The meeting today was advertised in the Forsyth County News. I think it's today. We'll talk about the contractors for these new jobs, which will also consist of two parking beds, not additional, two parking beds. So economic outlook is good, and a little bit to go along with that is the fact that we have the city of Cumming just recently completed a $32 million wastewater treatment facility. We've got a state-of-the-art facility with approved for the state of Georgia, and the EPD and the Environmental Protection Division of the county. Also, We have a $17 million water facility that's intake Lake Lanier that we think will last coming in Forsyth County for another 50 years. We have currently an expansion of hospital facilities. I'll mention a little bit more about that later. And also we have an expansion of the intersections of Buford Dam Road, Buford Dam to Sanders Road, also Marilis Park Road and intersection. The Kettlebell intersection will be a new project that I mentioned State Representative Mark Hamilton and Jack Murphy, Senator, worked with us on. We get state approval with some state aid for that intersection, which is a long overdue intersection that needs revamping, and we're going to be revamping that intersection. A new road that we're going to be working on is a new cut-through road from Ball Ridge Marina at the Boys Lodge to Pilgrim Mill Road. That'll be a new facility that'll be under construction by the end of the year. Some of the things that are currently under construction that is helping our economy is the $24 million complex of the Readiness Center, which is the Georgia National Guard. That's a project that the city started work on some 5 years ago, working with the state and federal government. State of Georgia, with the help of Senator Murphy and Mark Hamilton and Senator Gooch, kept $6 million in state budget for this project, along with $18 million of federal money. And this center will be open for the National Guard reservists, which will can handle up to 400 military veterans. And we'll be cutting ribbon on that in the fall of this year. Great facility. It's going to be used also by the community. They have great rooms that can assist in a lot of meetings at the center. And they look forward to being a community center at the National Guard. As I said, Northside Forsyth Hospital, we couldn't get by without it. Been issued permits by our planning department and starting a $50 million phase at the facility that we currently have. So that's a great complex that certainly all of us want, but hope we don't have to use anytime soon. Some of the other things that's going on to help boost our economy, as I was talking about, we issued permits, or I say we did, the city planning department, permit department issued grading permits for a new Costco that's going to be going in off the Pilgrim Mill Road, the intersection of 400 and Ball Ridge Road and Purple Ferry Road. That's a new project that we can't wait to get open. They say they're going to employ 150 people and going to have $125 million annual sale. So we look forward to having Costco be in our community. Also, as Commissioner Amos alluded to, we're going to be having a new courthouse, a five-story courthouse, a four-story jail. You know, as Commissioner alluded to, we finally got the sales tax passed to build this facility. It'll be paid for in 6 years, and all the money will come out of SPLOS. After 4 years of election, we had an election for a courthouse and jail to be built between 400 and Pilgrim Mill, which failed. We had a courthouse that was proposed to be built on where Wycova Bank stood, along with the Goodson's Drug in that area, and that failed. And we also had a courthouse and jail to be on Veterans Parkway, where Citizens Bank sat now, and that failed. And one of the reasons it did was because the people didn't want to pay for it through property tax. So after this group of commissioners got in, and I commend them, we got together with the city of Cumming, they got together with us, and we set out a plan that we would pay for this courthouse and jail out of sales tax money. It would be paid for in 6 years. It wouldn't be added on to the property tax. And at the end of the time, we had a bill of sale where the facilities was no debt. And the property owners wouldn't have to be paying for it for 30 years. So we were glad that the people of Cumming and Forsyth County decided that it was time, and we all got behind it and supported that. And we had a $100 million count on the jail and courthouse. And out of that $100 million, the city of Cumming initially committed to $12.5 million that the city will put in. And we're working, and we'll have another $1.3 million that we're adding to that. So that'll be $13.8 million that the city's going to commit to this $100 million project. And we're very pleased and gratified that we have a board of commissioners that unanimously supported this way to fund this, along with the city council. You know, one of the things that I was asked sometime back, that what was the hardest challenge that you as mayor and the city has had as being public officials of a growing town like Cumming. And I thought a while, and I thought, well, it could be the economic challenge, it could be the employment challenge, but I said, no, I believe it's working with the Forsyth County Board of Commissioners, not the biggest challenge. But in doing so, I'm glad to say that, and I said, one of the things that the commissioners seem to have done in the past, they treated myself and the city council like we're a bunch of Democrats. But I can say that most recently, the commissioners have been most generous, and we've been able to work together, and we look forward to working together for Cumming and Forsyth County for a better future. Thank you all for having us today.
You know, it's impressive to sit and listen to the accomplishments of Cumming and Forsyth. And if you think about it, just what's already been said today, you know, new infrastructure, be it roads or municipal facilities, new growth, you've got the hospital offices and a strong tax base, and an impressive demographic, residential growth. That's a really amazing set of characteristics for Cumming and Forsyth. Add to that quality of life that's out here, it's really amazing. But frankly, none of it happens, or it's certainly not sustained, without good education. So I think it can't be overstated the importance of education and that whole mix. You know, I was struck by the mission of the chamber, the chamber's motto, to build, grow, and succeed. You're definitely doing that out here, and it shows. And but I want to take a minute and focus on education. Nobody better to do that than the chair of the Board of Education, Darla Light. Mrs. Light has served as elementary and middle school officer. She's coached youth and middle school basketball. She's active in North Forsyth 400 Rotary Club. She and her husband reside in Forsyth with their three children. So, Darla Light.
I just told Pete I thought they saved the best for last. The Forsyth County School District is proud to be one of the top districts in our state, as well as in the United States. We've had other school districts from all over North America to come visit to learn how we're using technology in the classroom to increase student achievement, and also what we're doing to improve operational efficiency. Our success has been accomplished because of the dedication of our whole community, all of our stakeholders, starting with the students and going all the way to you, all of our business and community leaders. I'm a sixth generation Forsyth County. I think Rupert can probably attest to that, but I think I'm a sixth-generation Forsythian, and I graduated from Forsyth County High School, which was the only high school at that time. And I truly believe that our schools were founded on big, bold ideas, where the journey to greatness begins with the belief that anything is possible. When I graduated, I think there was about 20,000 people in the county. Now we have 39,102 students in our schools today. And my future, as well as yours, depend on those students. We need to ensure that they're afforded an opportunity for the best education possible here in Forsyth County. We have a short video now that will show you what our schools and the future holds.
After completing three very successful strategic plans, Forsyth County Schools dedicated the 2012-2013 school year to constructing a new plan to guide the district to 2016. This plan was developed with community and staff input. The new strategic plan describes our priorities and provides a strong path to greatness. Greatness comes from within. Our path to greatness begins with an unwavering belief that any dream can be realized for any child. The district works collaboratively with staff, parents, citizens, and businesses to support our primary customer, the individual student. To prepare each student to be college and career ready, Forsyth County Schools utilizes a learner profile that describes the attributes of students attending and graduating from a Forsyth County school. As the third fastest growing school district in the United States, Forsyth County Schools has added 8,000 new students in 5 years. Additionally, during this period, 6 new schools have opened to total 35 bricks and mortar schools and 1 virtual 6-12 school. However, the district's operational budget has not increased in those 5 years. As the 9th largest school district in Georgia, Forsyth County Schools continues to maintain the lowest tax rate in Metro Atlanta and the lowest expenditures per child. Great is accepting no limits. For the first time in 15 years, there are no funds available for capital improvements to support the student growth, such as renovations and modifications, additions and new school construction. 15 schools are over capacity, including 4 of the 5 county's high schools. Across the district, class sizes are at their max, and the number of trailers will be doubling at our schools this August. Our growth is projected to continue with an estimated 7,000 new students being added in the next 5 years. Throughout 2013 and 2014, Forsyth County Schools will be constructing the 2014 to 2019 facilities plan to address instructional needs such as curriculum programs, career, technical and agricultural education, special education, and technology support, as well as facilities, safety and security improvements, and financing needs for the next 5 years. Help us on our path to greatness by providing us with input on the 2014 to 2019 facilities plan. Visit www.forsyth.k12.ga.us/plan or scan the QR code in the district flyer at your seat. Thank you for your continued support. We appreciate your input as we continue our path to greatness.
As parents and grandparents and aunts and uncles, we all want what's best for our children. And as a business community, we know that a strong school system is a must to ensure a quality workforce and economic growth for our future. Forsyth County Schools deliver greater results for less money than any other districts around the metro area. And all of this information is in the flyer on your tables. And in that flyer, there's also a survey about our facilities plan. We would really appreciate your input if you can take a few moments to fill that out for us. We'd like to have the input as we move forward with the operational and capital funding needs. And Jennifer, now I'm going off space. I just want to take 1 second to say, they always make fun of me because they say I always have a story. But I just want to tell y'all how lucky that you are that even in these economic times that we have a superintendent and a cabinet that are phenomenal. I mean, they do, we've had less and less money and they do more and more things. And we are so lucky and blessed. They're a pleasure to work with. And the rest of the school board, we may not always agree because we all have different passions, but at the end of the day, what we all want is what's best for our children. And they're such good people. And I think Forsyth County is so blessed to have the leadership all the way from the school board down to the teachers in our education today. And as always, our district is grateful to have strong partnerships with the City of Cumming and Forsyth County government, as well as all of our local businesses. We look forward to working with you to continue to raise the bar higher for public education, not only in Georgia, but in the nation. And I'd like to just say thank you, thank you, thank you for your continued support of our students and staff. Our success would not be possible without you, all of our business leaders, and our community support. Thank you.
Thanks, Laura. You know, I think other communities in the metro area can learn from the cooperation that we see between Cumming and Forsyth, and certainly other school districts, be it DeKalb or Clayton or City of Atlanta, can learn a few things from you all. So appreciate your leadership in that area. Now it's time for question and answer. So now it's y'all's turn. You got the two chairmen and the mayor up here, the leadership. So if you got any questions, fire away. We've got a few minutes talking about strategic plans, loss votes, whatever you want to cover. The floor is open. Don't make me call on you now. Start calling people out here in a minute. You guys have any questions for them?
Look like I can give them all the information they want.
You got websites and everything up there.
Yeah.
Surely somebody's got something on their mind.
Yeah, if you get outside of some mountain, you're too far from home.
Question over here?
We are working on several solutions for that, but we're at the point where we're going to have to do something. And there's several different scenarios that's going to be going on at our board meetings in the next few months about the different ways that we can help solve that problem. Well, from a funding standpoint, and we want to, you know, expand schools, build more schools. What's the smartest thing to do with the money, with the taxpayer money, and just, you know, all of our different options?
I guess this question will be for the mayor. A few years ago, before the downturn, we had the resort project planned for Great Island Park. I just wonder, is that dead or is there any updates on that?
That died when the economy went to tank some 3 years ago, 4 years. They were being financed, I think, $125 million through Merrill Lynch. We all know what happened here and all that. So that went away, and we still have the 50-year lease with the Corps of Engineers and working with the General in Mobile and the Corps. We still have that lease, and obviously we have 100-acre tract of land on the peninsula of Maryland Park that we'd like to get with some big corporate to put a project over there. We got, as I alluded to earlier, we got a lot of projects going on. Before the end of this year, the City of Cumming will have the most permitted projects in the history of the City of Cumming. We'll have $250 million in construction work going on before the end of this year. So that's helping the economy a lot. We're gonna be putting over 300 people to work permanently and gonna have over 500 part-time jobs here in the construction.
Next question. I got a question. Mayor, we've had a lot of successes up here in Chairman Amos. What keeps you awake at night? What do you guys worry about the most
Things seem to be flowing nicely. What do you guys look for? What's your biggest concern?
Well, one of the big concerns was whenever you had all the economists on TV, they were talking about the economy throughout the whole country going to the tank, and one of my biggest concerns was how are we going to keep our 150 people that works for the city of Cumming job? That was one of the things. And then, of course, we talk about the increase in health care with the Obamacare going on and the additional taxes, which wasn't supposed to cost anybody anymore except the high 2% of the payers. And now we fair to say that the Obamacare and everything else that goes on, everybody's taxes went up. But basically, it was important for our community. Okay.
I guess one of the biggest challenges to our county, just working, you hear me? Is working within our budget. It's time to get our budget ready and keep our business rate as low as we can to spare any increase in taxes to our people. We've got some great projects, as the mayor Gravitt said, going on with a combination of city income and side county projects. So a big worry is keeping our business rate so people find it very attractive to move here. Everything's going good. We have buildings going on. Of course, it adds people to school. I know that. But right now, Forsyth County, if you mention Forsyth County anywhere around the state, people stand back and look at you kind of with some awe, like, what are y'all doing up there? So we're doing good right now. So thank you.
Sure.
I think the biggest challenge that we face, I've been on the school board 5 years, and when I started, we had the same budget practically that we have now. And we've added, I think, 8,000 students in those 5 years. And we're still educating them with the same amount of money. I don't feel like the students have suffered. I think that we've trimmed and cut and done a great job at it. And that's what I commend the central office for. But there comes a point when you can't do any more without harming the education. And I just don't think there's any way that we can sacrifice our children's education. And that's the thing that's the most worrisome, I guess.
Okay. Anybody else? Electrical? There you go.
We feel very confident George Powell was on EMC to furnish a lot of power for us. As long as we pay for it. But the growth, we may be a little bit behind the county in our infrastructure. We need to get on some roads and get them built. But that often comes down to SPOS dollars. Like I said, our sales taxes are increasing from 1 year to the next. But we need to get our infrastructure going to keep a little ahead of the construction we have going on now.
In 2003 and 4, the city had a budget of about $32 million. At the low peak, we had a budget of $21 million. We cut without furloughing employees. As Darla alluded to, we made cuts where it didn't hurt their employees. And we made sure that we had the money to do what needed to be done, but we cut. Today we have a budget of about $24 million. We talk about the infrastructure. As I said in my speech, we had $32 million state-of-the-art wastewater treatment facility, and certainly we're ahead of the curve with that. We've got the lowest point of withdrawal for water coming in Forsyth County and Lake Lanier, and we think that'll be good for another 50 years. And as the commission chairman alluded to, we think we got a lot of power source from Georgia Power and Sony, our local Sony EMC. So we're very happy with that part. And the infrastructure is in probably the best shape it's ever been in for the city of Cumming. Thank you very much.
Yes?
A lot of the projects and things that are going on here make living in Forsyth very attractive. But we hear a lot about people who move here and work in Alpharetta, working with that. What are we doing to improve through government to attract more business here?
What are we doing to improve government to attract more business here?
Well,
fundamentally, of course.
I'll start it off here. Obviously, we work with North Georgia College, State University. The city had to make contributions to get them to build a campus here. That attracted certainly something that be paying great dividends to the children and community of Cumming-Forsyth County for many, many years to come. We're working with the Costco organization. That's going to bring in additional 150 jobs, not accounting the sales tax that they'll annually pay off that $125 million projected gross income. So these kind of things, we're continuously working in the National Guard headquarters that's going to be able to facilitate for 400 military reservists that can be sent from the coming location right here off Pilgrim Mill Road at Aquatic Center with a flip of a pen from the governor sent anywhere a national emergency comes up. So we're very fortunate to be able to have contacts with all the various state and federal organizations and a lot of businesses. One of the key things that a lot of businesses want to locate, as Commission Chairman alluded to, the locating Cumming-Forsyth County. When you come to Cumming-Forsyth County, you have the lowest tax rate, and when you come to the city of Cumming, you still have the lowest tax rate because we have zero property tax. So these are some of the things that we've worked on over the years to facilitate additional growth for Cumming-Forsyth County. You look at the commercial and industrial growth, we only have about 10% of the county that's involved in commercial and industrial growth. So we've got a long way to go to catch up, and these are the commercial and industrial industries is what pays a lot of taxes for their schools and education, so that's what we're working on.
Thank you, Mayor. One of the problems we do have is along the corridor with Fulton County, people are working in Fulton, moving to Forsyth for our home, Texas. And we are upside down some of what getting businesses away from Fulton County. We're working very hard to bring businesses and jobs to this county. We want the high-paying technology-type jobs. A hospital is expanding, as Mayor alluded to, hiring more people at the hospital. But our main object is looking to our great Chamber of Commerce leader, James McCoy. We look to him to bring these businesses up here for us. Without a good chamber, we can't do anything without them. So it's up to them to help us bring these businesses, and we will help the businesses to locate here. So we appreciate anything James McCoy can do for us in the chamber. Thank you.
One more question in the back?
It seems like that the taxes are very important to the county and, of course, to the city of Cumming. I'm just asking, why is it that we only have three or four Saturdays, generally speaking, between Thanksgiving and Christmas? Why is it that we have a Christmas parade down a major marketplace boulevard that cuts a Saturday sales basically in half? Walmart last year was down $130,000. Dollar revenue. I'm Lance and Lance's Jewelry. We basically get our Saturday cut in half. Is there anything we can do about that to where we can move the parade to somewhere else? I'm not trying to be anti-Christmas, but I'm also, we only have, you know, three to four Saturdays, which is a big shopping day between them. I'd like to hear your responses. Thank you.
We were hoping this parade would bring people to town and spend the money. And if it's doing the opposite, we apologize for that. We work these individuals and corporations to put this parade on and hope, like I said, it brings people into our city and into the county. We will have to work this, and maybe it's a good question to see if we can't move it, but we can look for some answers for that question.
That's a good question.
It is a good question, and we've been asked that a lot of times, but keep in mind that this parade is sponsored by mostly the merchants and businesses, and the reason is to kick off the Christmas holiday, and it's not the City of Cumming parade. If the merchants decided they didn't want it, I think that, you know, it could be moved to to the square in Cumming, or, but the reason for it was to get people to come and start the kickoff for the Christmas holidays.
Okay, thank you for the question. One more bonus question. Yes. Sure, why not?
We have got several things in place that will pick up our security in all of our schools, but that's a good idea, and I will take it to our our safety department, and that's always an option, right? When the money's not there, that's an option. Right. That's exactly right. That's a good option. Thank you.
Great comments and questions. Well, thank you very much. Jennifer, can you put the sponsors back up on the screen? I want to thank our sponsors today from top to bottom. What a great turnout. It's really comforting to see sponsors step up to this program. Thank you to our panelists, to our speakers. Thank you for your attendance today. And with that, we are adjourned. Thank you.
and nobody wants to do it. Can you imagine that? Yeah, I know. Well, luckily we had really easy transition.
They're not shaking it.